Hello friends, welcome to my channel Sky is the Limit. In today's video, I will demonstrate how to get a 3D model from MRI and CT scan images. If you find the video useful, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. The package which we will be using to convert the images is the 3D Slicer. The 3D Slicer is an open source software platform for medical image informatics, image processing and three-dimensional visualizations. The link to install this software is available in the description. Once you have installed the software and open the software, the GUI of the software will be like this. Now whenever you want to use this package, the major problem is from where to get the MRI and CT scan images. If you are not having the images, no problem. In this particular package, you have some sample data which you can use and generate the 3D model. Now, as you open this software, you will see an option download sample data. Once you click on this download sample data, you can see that there are sample CT scan and MRI images of some human body parts is available for demonstration. So I will just try to use a sample CT scan image is available for the chest. Once you click on it, it will take some time to upload those images and it will be visible on the right side of the screen. After this, now the task is to segment the images such that the required body part is generated and you are able to see the 3D model of it. Once you have uploaded the data, the next step what you have to do is you have to go to segmentation. In the upper toolbar, if there is a drop down menu, if you click on the arrow, you will find segment editor. Click on segment editor. Once you click on the segment editor, you will be getting an option to add a new segment. Click on add. You can name this segment as per your convenience. I will try to separate out the spinal cord from the complete chest model. So I will name it as spinal cord. You can even change the color so that it is clearly visible. So I will give it a bright color so that I can clearly see it on the screen and say select. Once you have named the segment, now the task is to separate out the spinal cord from the complete set of the images. If you see here, you can just slide on this and it is a set of multiple images. So you can see the images as you slide this in three views. So this is for visualization. If you want to see a particular part in detail, you can just slide the slider in any of the image and you can see what the image is depicting. Now, in order to do segmentation, there are many tools available over here. The best tool which I prefer is by segmenting using the threshold value. Once you have segmented it, other tools can be used for editing. So once you click on threshold, if you see whatever is appearing pink means that is being selected. So I want to separate out the spinal cord from this complete set of images. So you can change the threshold value either by changing this slider bar or by manually changing the values. So the best, initially it is better to slide the bar and just see what is being displayed on the screen. So once I change this, if you see, so this is the So here you should judge that, okay, the outer selection has been lost and I am just able to see this. So here also this is the spinal cord, right? So you have to change the threshold such that only the spinal cord is visible or is appearing as the color which you have chosen. So here also you can see, so I will just move this to a sufficient value so that I could see the spinal cord only. and then we will be doing the editing. Once you have done a sufficient editing of the threshold value such that the required area is highlighted, you have to click on apply. After you apply this threshold value and the geometry is selected, you can see the 3D view of it. For that, just scroll up and click on show 3D. Depending upon your system, it will take some time to generate the 3D. Now, if you can see, the 3D model will be generated in this window, and you can just click on the left mouse click and see what is being generated. So sufficiently, okay, at least I could select the bone part, and at least I could segment the tissue part from the selected geometry. Addition can be done once you have got a scratch model. Now there are many tools for their addition, editing the image geometry which is being generated. The best thing which I find suitable is using the scissor. Now once I click on scissor, what we can do is we can go to any of the window and just cut the unwanted geometry. So here, this particular part, I know this is something extra which has been selected. So I'll just draw a boundary by clicking the left mouse button, and I will close the boundary. So what will happen, whatever be is enclosed in that particular boundary will be removed from the selected part. So this has been removed. Now I don't want these ribs, okay, I don't want the ribs. So what I will do, I will again draw a boundary such that everything which is not required, I will select that and it will be removed. So see, this has been removed. I can select here also, whichever image you are finding that okay, you can identify it, you can select it. Again, if you select on scissor, it will be deselected, or you can. So I will try to modify my selected geometry by removing some more unwanted geometry. So as I told you, you have to just select it in whichever view you can see it, and just remove the things which is not required. So it takes some time and needs some judgment. So you can just move the images and try to see which is not required. So you can see by using the scissor tool, I can just remove my unwanted geometry and I can just keep the required part which I am interested in to analyze it for further study. So you can use the scissor tool and you can just work on the images and just get the required geometry 3D model. Now once you are satisfied with the generated model, the next task is to save it in a compatible file so that you can just open the file in the required software. So I will tell you how to save it in .stl file, and I will try to open it in a 3D slicing software also. So once you have done with this, you again need to go to the drop down menu. And there below the segment editor, you can find segmentation. Now once you click on segmentation and just scroll down, you will find a tab where it has been written export to files. Now here, when in export to files, you can select the required folder where you want to save the file. So I have just selected a folder which is slicer in my C drive, right? So my file will be saved over here, and here you can select the file format which you want. So I will keep it as STL file. Now once you have done this, you have to click on export. Once you have exported it, you can see that the file has been generated in the selected folder. Now once you are satisfied with this, what we will do, we will try to open it in a slicing software for 3D printing. So I am using the Ultimaker Cura software, in which I will try to open that file, and we will see whether it is we are able to see the same model in this slicing software. So I will just try to file, open files, and I will select the segment spinal cord which is being generated. So I will just click on open. So you can see the geometry is here, but it is not as per the specification of my printer. It is going beyond the maximum area. So what I will do, I will just try to scale it so that we can see it. So this is my geometry, and I will just try to move it in the workable area. So you see, I have imported it in my software. You can rotate it, you can do all those things. So there is another video in which we will be demonstrating it, how to use this software for 3D printing. Okay, so thank you friends for watching this video. If you find it useful, please like the video and do subscribe to the channel.